just want to quickly give us a lecture about the termites here. A very special thing to see here. We all sometimes ask our question, why? We have this stamp here. We have this stamp of the tree, and actually we have this termite strangling the stamp of the tree. This wood here actually is no longer living, but you find termites in that. Why it's like this? You know, in nature, everything that is sucked back to nature. This is a wood termite that strangled this piece of the wood. Actually, they're eating the wood, and wherever it's put, it becomes what? Home. That's the reason you find the trees like this. Actually, it happens like this. You know that the termite that are involved here, it's a wood termite. And the way back historical of us as Shangaan tribe, we have sometimes touched the method that the termites do. Remember in the area, I want to give you the history of the Nguni people that were settled. As I'm one of the Nguni, I'm a descendant of the Nguni tribe. So here you see, way back, I'll take you in 1600 in the area. It was very difficult for the Shangaan or the Nguni people to survive in the area. So they have to take natural resource as an example how they do things, and exactly they do the same. So here, as a wood termite shows here, I would like to give a question, although it would be very much difficult. You know, way back before the Dutch people entered the area, they found Shangaan people or the Nguni people living such a very difficult life as it was. So what they've done with the life of an African people. So the people, what they do here, they use the method of this wood termite to bury people around it, in surrounding. They used to convey the heart and put the roof, the heart in the grass. They put lots of thorns to stop anything that will access the body of the dead person inside the heart and live and migrate. So because of the wood termite here, if the wood termite comes around and find the grass and the wood is dead, they actually crawl up and eat the grass. Actually, after eating the grass, because wherever it's food, it becomes home. What you do, they say, they'll start to strangle the shape of the heart, and it will become termite. Easy on that way. It's the method that they're using before the Dutch people entered the area. The Dutch dump somebody, roof the area, put grasses around, thorns on top of it to stop anything that will access the body. So the mellow circle of the bush, the combination, the symbiotic relationship that are here, it will take place on that grass. They start to eat grass, wherever it's food, it becomes home. So they want to strangle that part in the shape of what? Of that part. And it will become easily as a termite. So when the Dutch come, they come with technologies, they come with spade equipment and so on, then we're able to get to dig. But this is our historical background. As with the Nguni people, we used to do the same, and it was taking a long time. There's a reason today, some of the termites have been here for million years. We never even enjoy the right, figures of the year, because it takes a while to do that. So bear in mind, I know that the termites, some of the termites, this happens on that one, and the people, how they used to bury people, they're using this form to bury people around in the area. How I know this? I'm very young to talk about the history that happened way back. My grandfather died in the area. My grandfather died in the area. The information is just passed on to generation to generation. I'm still going to pass it on to my children, and my children are going to pass it on and on and on and on like that. It's something that I'm not mentioning through to the scripture. It's something that it happens, and my father taught me, really, always done, together with my grandfather. That is the knowledge. know that it's a wood termite that's involved there. And the way they're doing that is recycling everything back to the soil decomposed. That's the reason you find the tall grass around the termite mine. It's the recycle of nature.